Are you interested in protocols that have potentially 31,000% APY or more, maybe even millions in some cases? Or are you just interested in getting a basic yield much better than your banks on your US dollar, up to 20% in some instances? Well, you can do that in DeFi. I'm Steven, the calculator guy, and this is Introduction to DeFi, where I'm going to teach you what DeFi is, and then what some of the opportunities are on it. This is gonna be a two-part video series. Part one, what is DeFi? What can you do on it? And then part two, actually getting started with DeFi. So let's just jump right in with what is DeFi. DeFi is decentralized finance, which is the opposite of centralized finance. With centralized finance, if you want to access financial tools, you have to go through a third-party entity. So if you want to participate in the stock market, you have to go through a broker. If you want to participate in getting loans, you need to go through a bank. Now, in those instances, you need to get permission from those entities, and that permission could be based on any number of qualifiers, like your credit score, your income level, your age, etc. With DeFi, everything is permissionless, which means anywhere in the world with access to internet can access the most robust financial tools in the world without permission, which is absolutely amazing. Furthermore, it is trustless. What that means basically is that instead of relying on a person or corporation to use your funds responsibly, you're relying on smart contracts, which are just financial agreements that are hard-coded into things we call protocols. And as long as you trust those smart contracts, which are generally audited by a third party, then you can trust that your funds are completely safe and that no person can take those funds from you on that protocol. Because again, it is all being done automatically through immutable smart contracts, immutable code. All right, next, you actually own your assets. This is really big to me. It could be the case that if you have assets on the stock market, if you have assets in a bank, for whatever reason, those assets could be seized or frozen, right? We've definitely heard of frozen accounts before, in the event of like bankruptcy or defaulting on loans. With DeFi, no one can touch your assets except for you, unless you give them permission or you give them your seed phrase. Otherwise, your assets are untouchable. They are yours. Now, this is particularly amazing. These assets can't be seized. They cannot be frozen without your permission. Okay, next, all these protocols are available 24/7. The stock market shuts down every day at a certain time. DeFi does not. Crypto never sleeps. You can do lending, borrowing, leveraging, all of this stuff at any time of the day. So clearly, DeFi is full of investment opportunities. So let's just jump right into what some of those investment opportunities are. My contemporaries in the DeFi space may get mad at me for my definition of staking, but I'm going to simplify it as much as I possibly can. Staking just means, again, this is a colloquial definition, providing an asset to a protocol for yield. Now, the true definition of staking, the original definition of staking, has more to do with validator nodes, but we're not going to get into that. Basic staking, providing an asset under protocol for yield. So for example, on Anchor Protocol, you can provide your UST, your stablecoin, pegged to the dollar, 1-to-1 ratio, onto the Anchor Protocol just by clicking deposit and get a yield of roughly 20% APY. And that is a consistent yield that has been there months and months and months running. This is one of the most trusted protocols in DeFi, and you can see it has $10 billion locked onto it. Okay, so you can also get yields on your Ethereum, you can get yields on your Terra, you can get yields on virtually any token that exists, yields on Bitcoin through staking onto particular protocols. So that is staking. There are many reasons why people want you to stake, but to understand that, you'd have to go into a deeper protocol analysis, which we're not going to do in this particular video. Next, liquidity providing. This is probably the biggest source of revenue on DeFi, on these different chains and protocols. So liquidity providing is where you provide assets onto exchanges so that when swaps occur, there's not a large price impact. For example, if you want to buy a bunch of Avalanche token, AVAX, with your USDT, your dollars, and let's just say there wasn't very much liquidity in AVAX, so there's only like a few tokens, and you try to buy those, your demand would be very high relative to the supply on that protocol, which means the value of AVAX would rise to meet that demand, which means you would have a very large price impact with your purchase. To avoid that, you need a lot of AVAX and a lot of UST on this platform so that there's minimal price impact. And that's where liquidity pools come in. You can see there are millions of dollars locked in all these liquidity pools, and those liquidity pools are generating an APR. That APR comes from swaps. Every time someone swaps between two assets, there's a tiny fee that's being incurred. That fee goes to the liquidity pool providers. So you can see 43%, 22%. You can provide liquidity from two stablecoins, so both pegged to the dollar, and get 21% APR. Pretty freaking good. Now, sometimes these protocols will additionally incentivize liquidity pool providing. Those are farms. When the protocol, the exchange says, hey, we really need more liquidity here, we're willing to pay you in our own token for you to provide liquidity. So here's an example. This GOM AVAX pair. The base rate fee APR is 15.8%. However, they're willing to pay you an additional 25% in their proprietary token for you to provide that liquidity. So you're going to go from 15% from the fees to a 40% APR because it's incentivized from the protocol. So pooling, just basic liquidity, generating fees, farming, additionally incentivized by the protocol. Okay, next. And there are plenty of different kinds of farms. You can actually leverage those up to get much more APY and APR. Or you can also have these auto-compounded for even more APR and APY. Beefy is probably my favorite auto-compounder. So if we look at their protocol on the Avalanche chain, you can see in some cases you have thousands of percents of APY, which is amazing, but of course more volatile tokens. All right, so liquidity pool providing, you're providing liquidity, you're getting fees from the swaps, you're also potentially getting farming rewards from the protocol. You can auto compound those so that you're not exposed to those farming rewards. You can also leverage those for even more rewards. Let's talk lending. So borrowing and lending is really, really big in DeFi for a number of reasons. But in order to just understand getting yield, just know that you can lend your assets and you can borrow against those assets. So maybe you want to park your stable coins and then buy some tokens to go get yield on them, or for whatever reason. You could lend your UST or USDC and get 8% to 9% yield on that just for lending it, and then you can borrow against it. So there are also many other places you could do this. So one of them is a beautiful, wonderful leveraging yield farm called Alpha Homora. Not my favorite yield farm, but a really good one. And this is, again, leverage yield farm. In order to leverage, there need to be, if you want to leverage, you need to borrow assets, right? So to leverage 3x and get a higher yield on those farms, you need to borrow two times what you provide. Well, who are you borrowing from? I'll give you a hint. In DeFi, you're always going to be borrowing from other people, which is amazing. And those other people are earning APYs and APRs off of your borrows. So you're getting a higher yield from leveraging. They're getting a yield from you borrowing their assets. It's a very symbiotic system. So here you could provide your AVAX, which is I consider a blue chip token. You can provide your USD, UST for 10%. And there you go. Okay, so that is lending. There are plenty of different lending opportunities, but it's just something you can do. Finally, let's talk about one other very cool thing you can do. There are so many cool things you can do in DeFi. This is just one of them, and that is liquidating. So everything that the big whales and the big financial institutions do, like they take care of all the liquidating, they get all the beautiful discounts on liquidated assets, the people do in DeFi, which is amazing. So here you would place a bid using your stable coins, and then if someone gets liquidated and your bid is in a particular range, you will get their assets at a discount. And if you wanted, you could sell those assets immediately for a profit. So it's been said to me before, and it is absolutely true, anything that exists in centralized finance exists in DeFi faster, quicker, and more profitable. Anything that the financial institutions can make money off of, the individuals can make money off of in DeFi. This is simply the tip of the iceberg. Again, if you go to DeFi Llama, you can just see all the different protocols that exist. I will tell you, there are some protocols with thousands of percents APY. There are some protocols with millions of percents APY. And there are so many opportunities. There are delta neutral strategies, which means, you know, you're not exposed to price action. You can see here we have 9.18% million percent APY on a potentially stable coin pair that operates through Signerage, which is a really cool financial mathematical interaction. All this is to say, there is some cool stuff in DeFi. So in the next video, we're going to talk about how to get started with DeFi, how to create a decentralized finance wallet, how to get money onto that wallet, and how to get started interacting with protocols all over the space. If you guys want to ask me questions in real time and have me answer within 24 to 48 hours, please go ahead and join my Patreon. I always answer questions there within 48 hours, and we talk about a lot of the more advanced protocols there and money-making opportunities, and I would like to think we do pretty well. Otherwise, thank you guys so much for watching, and have a wonderful rest of your day.